ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the St. Tammany Parish Planning Meeting of April the 8th. Everybody can hear me on this one, I think. We're working with the sound, so. Little clerk, please call the roll.
Ms. Casabon? Mr. Lauren? Mr. Hines? Mr. Richard? Mr. Willie is not here. Mr. Matthews? Mr. Davis? Mr. Manella? Mr. Drum? Mr. Randolph? Should be here shortly.
Thank you. Announcements, please turn your phones and pagers at least on vibrate or off. If you disagree with anything that comes out of this commission, you have the right to appeal it to the council. There are appeal cards over on the banister there to my right. Same is true with speaker cards. If you have a case that you'd like to speak on, please fill out a speaker card and turn it into staff and they'll get it up here to us. Each side on cases will have 10 minutes and then there'll be a 5-minute rebuttal. If you want to talk about a case, please exit the building. Don't just go out in the foyer out there because the sound please comes back in this area. Please rise for the invocation.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right. We had in your packets there was the March 11th minutes. Hopefully everybody had an opportunity to review them. Any corrections needed to be made, or if not, I'll accept a motion to approve.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Matthews, seconded by Mr. Lauren. Please vote. Motion carries. Thank you. The next few items are on what we refer to as a consent calendar. Any items not pulled from the consent calendar are automatically dispensed by vote as approved and or as per staff comments. Items pulled from the consent calendar shall be discussed and voted upon individually. Staff, I believe you probably have some that need to be pulled.
Yes, sir. The first one, MS 1403-014, and on the second page, MS 1403-016 needs to be pulled.
Okay, and we have a card here that's asking for the Ozone Park subdivision, Bode Lane, Pine Street, to be pulled. So I will accept a motion to pull.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
I'd like to pull the MS 1403-014.
We've got it. Pull it up. Yeah.
Okay. And 15.
15 doesn't. 16 is the one that needs.
Well, I know. I want to pull that one too.
Yeah. Okay.
All three of them.
15. I want to pull all of them. All except the Ochsner Boulevard.
Okay. We have. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Seconded by Mr. Davis. So we're pulling Ozone Park subdivision. That's the first item under the entering parish rights of way. We're pulling MS 1403-04 on page 2. We're pulling 015 and 016. We have a motion and a second. Please vote to pull those. Motion carries. All right, the first item is Ozone Park subdivision, Bode Lane.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
Don't we need a motion to pass
the only yes, we do. Yes, we do. I'll accept a motion to move on the remaining item. Moved by Mr. Matthews, seconded by?
Me.
Seconded by Mr. Davis. Please vote on entering the Parish right-of-way on the Ochsner Boulevard. Motion carries. Thank you. All right. First item we're going to hear is Ozone Park Subdivision, Bodie Lane, Slant Pine Street, Ward 4, District 5. Request to enter the Parish right-of-way for the purpose of gaining access to property. The debtors, McCallman LLC, Parish Council Representative is Honorable Marty Gould, excuse me. Staff, do you have any comments on that one?
No comments.
No comments from the staff on that. All right, Elizabeth Bolick, you asked this be pulled?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
Good evening, members of the Planning Commission and staff. As you know, my name is Elizabeth Bolick. My husband and I own the property that abuts the unopened portion of Pine Street along its entire northern boundary, a distance of approximately 500 feet. I want to make it clear up front that I acknowledge McCallman LLC has the right to access their property through the unbuilt portion of Bodie and Pine Street, and I respect that right. When I first saw this public notice, I was saddened. The neighborhood children use those woods as a place to play. They have a treehouse in the back, and they also climb the skeletal remains of a small live oak. Close to where the public notice itself sits, they shelter under a wax myrtle and playhouse. Unlike so many of today's children, they're not on iPhones, using Xboxes or Facebook, and they're playing as many of us used to play, and this is the last wild place near their homes. I wish that McCallman LLC would very generously choose to leave this space alone. They could do it, as McCallman LLC consists of two manager members who are extraordinarily wealthy people. They have no need of the money they would make from developing this small property. But that is their business, so I'll return to my two main points that I wanted to speak to you tonight about. One, assuming that you grant McCallman LLC the right to enter and open up Bodie/Pine Street, I expect you to apply all of the requirements that are in place for such entry. This includes, but is not limited to, Ordinance 2927, amending Chapter 20, Article 1, Section 20-011.01. There should be no waivers, as this is exactly the situation which Ordinance 2927 was intended to address when it was passed by our parish council. I might add that it was sponsored and introduced by our current district councilman, Marty Gould. Such requirements should include the placement of a road culvert on the east side of Orleans Avenue, arranging with CLECO to safely move the power line that presently sits in the dead center of the unopened Bodie and Pine Street, construction of a road with hard surfacing and drainage ditches that meets parish specs and is centered in the center of what is an existing 60-foot wide right-of-way, installation of sewer and water by virtue of connecting to St. Tammany utilities where they run within this old subdivision, as was established by that Ordinance 2927, liability insurance covering this work, and a performance bond to ensure completion. There should be no reasons for waivers of any kind with respect to this request. These lots were fairly recently purchased, and the purchaser should have known, or does know, that these requirements would apply to accessing and developing this land. I repeat, there should be no waivers of any kind. Item two, we have shared the use of Bodie Street, the built portion, with the manager members for many years. Our homes have a common boundary that exceeds 2,000 feet in length. Over that time, the manager members have acquired several successive bobcats and a large tracked excavator along with other equipment. Some time ago and without public notice, they used the bobcat and chainsaws to cut a path into this right-of-way that they now propose to enter. The bobcat swath extended around the back of our property at the eastern boundary within Brookstone subdivision. It actually cut into the lot belonging to that subdivision. Additionally, recent and prolonged work along Bodie Street has given us great concern over the employment of non-English speaking crews using such equipment with little or no regard to parish codes, safety considerations, respect for others' private property, or basic courtesy to the neighborhood. Whether from ignorance or arrogance, I cannot say, but I want protection from this kind of behavior should they be granted the right-of-way entry. Thank you for your attention and consideration of these comments. And I'd like to hand these in, if I may.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
I'm Sam Camp, and I am McCalman LLC. Appreciate you gentlemen tonight. I don't see Mr. Gould here tonight, though, is he?
No, he's not on the planning commission.
Yeah, okay. Well, I walked this with him, and I am the neighbors of these distinguished people here. And I would like to, if I might, I didn't bring a copy for everybody here, but I'd like to give you a copy that you could pass down. Can I present, come around and present that to you? Let me give you this right here. This is my driveway.
Let me go ahead and give it to him first so you can explain.
Okay, well, I won't see them, but I think I got them in order here. If I could show them to him, he can pass them down. Can I do that?
Well, just give them to Mr. Keller. And
okay.
And
well, I don't know, in sequence, if you can see them, if you'll pass them right here to the gentleman. The first photo that you see right there is coming out of my driveway. The house are there. My property is right there on Bode Lane. I'm on 139 Bode Lane. I own approximately 40 acres there in that area. You come out of my driveway on the side, you see the street right there in front of you. You move right down to Orleans Avenue. Is the next picture is Orleans Avenue. You see the white gates in front of that. That's Mr. Butch and Nib's driveway into their house. That is part of Orleans Avenue. I want you to know these people successfully a new years ago against Mr. Kramer got all that street closed. They built a facility on that street, and they closed approximately 75 or 80 feet or maybe 90 feet of that street. I do not know whether they own that street now. I have no idea. According to their listing of their house, they do not own that street. It's part of the Parish property. And so that's what's happening. You see down the other street, and the other two pictures is right across the property in the T section of that house there. I own those three lots at the end of Bode Lane in that group. I do not intend to build any houses, three houses in that property. If it is, I'll give you the map here. I would make those one piece of property if I ever built a house in there. I do not want to, they gave me all this stuff about the street. All I want in there, gentlemen, is a driveway. Simple driveway. Just like I've got to my house right there. And drive in and drive out. It'll be one entrance, one out. Simple driveway. No other houses built in there, if I ever build one there. But it's pretty amazing to me. You can close all of Orleans Street, and that street was open for 40 or 50 years. Mr. Kramer lost the right to use that street and get to his house. That's the reason that street that you see, that driveway that he had to build in order to get off that property, because of these neighbors we have. We're the people on Bode. If you want to go see it, it is a great street. We have a great a place there. It just so happens I have the most property on that street, front of about 600 or 700 feet down that street. So anyway, I'd welcome anybody to come and look and see. And all I would like to do is simply have a driveway, not a road, not Parish up to grade, all that, just a simple driveway into the house. So if I ever do it, just to the property. I'm not planning to build a house there. I'm not a contractor. I'm building some houses, but I am not a builder. So I don't know if there's any other questions about this, and I do have another map if you'd like to see where this goes to.
Yeah, right, we've got a pretty good map.
I think you got one there.
And the pictures are coming back down the one line right now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Yeah. Any other question, I'll be glad to answer.
There may be some questions. Yes. I just want to see if there's anyone else in the audience that wishes to speak on this.
Yes, sir. Appreciate it.
Okay. Is there anyone else in the audience that wishes to speak on this? Okay. Then we'll go into the rebuttal phase of it.
Well, it's strange to rebut something that isn't even relevant to tonight's topic.
I need you, the gentleman back here, he raised his hand. Do you want to speak?
He's our neighbor, and they were saying they were too nervous to speak to y'all. They're on the other side of the proposed entry. They're the house that abuts and faces out on Orleans where the street would go in beside them.
Okay. All right.
Do you want to speak, David or Juliet? No, I just, I'm puzzled at where Mr. Camp's going. The issue he's talking about is actually the old car line, which was 100-foot wide right-of-way that belonged to an old railroad. We actually have the rail bed. It was a privately owned line. We bought it from Nikki Behringer and Frank Costley. Al Kramer wanted to declare it a road so his wife could have a tradesman's entrance. That was her expression. We went to court, and it was adjudicated, and the court found that it was indeed our private property. So, you know, I don't know what it is. It's not even relevant to today, but it's disturbing to be attacked like that.
Okay. We're in rebuttal right now. Do you want to speak, sir?
Yes, sir, I do.
Okay. Come forward.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon.
Come to the mic, please.
Thank you. Good afternoon.
I need your name.
I'd just like to say my name is Lynn Bolick.
Okay.
And I live at 221 Orleans Avenue. And I'd like to make the point that Mr. Camp has already made a road in there. And that road abuts our property. We have a cypress shadow box fence that Libby and I built. We didn't have anybody built it for us. We built it. So there's already a road he's put in there that serves a purpose for which he talked about wanting a road in there tonight. So please make a note that that second hand just wanting a little drive in there. He's already got one. Used his own equipment, his track hoe, his bobcat, and any labor around there. So
okay.
I just wanted to make that point.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen. I have not made a road in there, nor have I cut anything in there. You'd be welcome to come out and see it. It's a trail that walks back in the droop. Here's a property that they say, it says here that building street within Bullock property does not, the 2 acres, the Bullocks do not have title to this, but they have use of it. Orleans Avenue had been open for almost 50 years, all the way to the Bode and the Kramers. So if it's not a street, the railroad happened to run right beside it, but the street was open too.
Okay. Thank you. Does anyone else wish to speak? All right, I'm going to close the floor to the public, bring it back to the commission. And Mr. Davis?
Yeah, Mr. Rhodes, is it? Is it Rhodes or?
Me.
Yes.
Camp, C-A-M-B.
Mr. Camp, would you come up here for a second, please?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I'm looking at a schematic of this Ozone Parks. And
yes,
sir. Your properties are in Section 30? Are they lots numbered?
No, it's no lots.
There's no.
Yeah, you want to see this section?
No, I'm looking at the sheet that we were given.
That was made in about 1908, 1900. That's no longer. That's not a
park. Okay, sir, but you have property in the back here, and you have property behind where you want the road to go. Is that correct? At the end of this road, the proposed road or entranceway, you own property behind that or adjacent to it? Well, does he need this access if he's got this front access? I don't understand.
I just want to drive way into the road. You see basically where that is?
No, I don't, actually.
Well, would you like me to point it out to you?
Looking at Bode Road, and I'm looking at Orleans Avenue.
Orleans Avenue is this section right there.
I'm looking at also from this previous older map. I understand that now. And do you own any of the properties that are in this square here?
No, that's for Mr. Bullock.
Okay, so this has nothing to do with this. So why would you need to gain access to this road?
Because I have all that property at the end there.
Here?
Right there below the road. No, right there.
Here.
All those.
Ah,
I have all of it property.
So you have this, okay, so you have lots 1, 2, 3, 4, 10A, 13A, and 15A.
Well, they're not there anymore. They're three lots now.
But you own these, you own this whole quadrant right here.
Right, and I want to make that one lot, not three, just one. I have to reverse that.
All right, but this whole quadrant
section
here is your property.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir.
So you're only asking
Just a driveway.
Gain access here to driveway to all these lots?
No, just one. It's only one lot there, sir. I just want a driveway.
Why can't you have the driveway be generated off of Orleans Avenue?
There's no, that's the house. You can't get there. It's a dead end street.
Oh, so you're saying that there's houses on these front lots?
Yes, sir.
Against Orleans, and you own the lots behind them?
Yes, sir.
Gotcha.
I got it.
I understand.
And the subdivision next to it, you can't get there.
Now. I understand. So
I just want a driveway.
Three lots in the back, according to this.
Yes, sir.
And you just want to have access to be able to get to these three lots.
Right. Just a driveway.
Which is fair. I mean, which
I
is,
don't know.
Which
I would think
is
so.
Fair. But to do that, you do have to build the road to code.
I know. You see the property on the other side there. I don't know about code.
No.
But I'm not going out there and construct a parish road.
You're going to have to, though, according to our procedures. Is this correct?
Well, it might be according to your procedures, but I just want a driveway. I don't want a road.
I understand that, but to gain access to your three properties, which you have the right to do, you will have to build that to code according to our.
Well, I tell you what, we need to make some exceptions to it.
Well, that's something that can be discussed.
Yeah.
Ron, yeah, I mean, all I can tell you is that this is how it's done. I mean,
I understand how it's done. I understand these things in this parish, how it's done.
Just a minute. Ron, if this is open and he wants to put any kind of a driveway or something like that, it has to be up to parish code because it's on a street right-of-way. Is that correct?
Chairman, this is your part. We'll confirm that. That's correct. Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Okay.
Yeah, the road would need to be constructed to parish standards for that right-of-way to
gain
access.
Whether he wants to call it a driveway or not.
Correct.
It's still going to be a parish road at that point in time.
Correct.
Okay. You understand that?
I understand that. Okay. I'm not willing to do that.
Okay.
Okay.
Mr. Matthews?
That makes a lot of the questions I had fairly easy. I make a motion to deny.
Second.
All right, we have a motion and a second to deny on Ozone Park Subdivision, the Bode Lane, Pine Street.
So you're saying you denying me the right to get to my property?
No, sir. No, sir.
What are you saying?
You have the right to get to your property.
Okay.
But if you build, if you open this right away and build in this right away, you must build a road up to parish code.
Okay.
And you said you're not willing to do that, so that's easy.
Yeah.
I made a motion to deny.
That'd be great. I'll be back. Don't worry.
Okay. We have a motion and a second to deny. Please vote. Motion carries. Thank you.
Mr. Dougherty, you might want to just let the gentleman know he does have the right of appeal to his councilman.
You understand about the appeal process? There's a
right to appeal. Oh, don't worry. I will. There's no problem. I'm no hurry.
Well, you've only got
you have 10 days.
10 days to file the appeal.
To make an appeal to your councilman, and Mr. McGool.
I'll make it to Mr.
You've got to fill out the
I'll be glad
to fill it out.
All right. Minor subdivisions. Next item is MS 14-03-014. Partials 5A1, 5A2, and 5A5 into parcels 5A1A, 5A5A, 6A, 6B, 7, and 8. Ward 1, District 1. The owner is Marmont Properties, LLC. The surveyor is Acadia Land Surveying. The Parish Council representative is Honorable Marty Dean. Staff?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This property is located on and off the East Brewster Road and Sterling Boulevard, south of Covington. It's a part of a prior minor subdivision, which they're taking part of it and creating six lots. One is a private servitude, so it doesn't count toward the total number of lots for the minor subdivision. The owner of the property is proposing to re-subdivide three lots within an existing minor subdivision into five buildable lots in a green space servitude. The proposal meets code with the exception of proposed parcel 6A, which does not meet the minimum 1 acre lot size requirement. Based on the amount of the total acreage within the proposed new minor subdivision, which is 34.15 acres, the staff fails to understand why the owner can't simply add an additional 0.74 acres to parcel 6A in order to comply with parish code. However, it should be noted that the parcel, as well as all the other parcels, are zoned commercial, in which district permits less than 1 acre parcels, but not part of the minor subdivision process. The staff recommends approval of the proposed minor subdivision request, subject to parcel 6A being increased to a 1 acre minimum lot size. Additionally, a waiver of the regulations is required if the commission so desires to approve relative to the lot size issue. A two-thirds majority vote of the full membership of the commission, which is 8 members, is needed in order to approve the waiver pursuant to section 40-100, waiver of regulations of ordinance 499.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Daugherty. Good evening. My name's Jeff Shane. I'm with the Jones Fussell Law Firm in Covington, and I represent Marmont Properties, both the owner and developer of this tract. I think you're all familiar with where the property is located, but it is just east of the Sam's development in River Chase, just south of I-12. Previously, through the development process of this project, one of the things that we had done was create a minor subdivision of 5 rather large tracts, and as you know, the code allows us to create additional minor subdivisions within each lot, provided you come before the Planning Commission and go through a public hearing process. Probably the only thing that is somewhat different or remarkable about this case is that one of the parcels obviously is not 1 acre. So I'd like to address that and ask you to maybe give some consideration toward a waiver. I have presented other cases like this to you in the past, and I think it is somewhat a shame that we have a conflict between the zoning ordinance, if you will, the Unified Development Code, and the minor subdivision ordinance, in that this parcel that you see, 6A of 0.926 acres, 40,338 feet, meets, if you will, the zoning parcel requirements. This parcel is in fact zoned PBC1, and actually the minimum lot size in a PBC1 is 20,000 square feet. So if we were going through the full subdivision process, and we presented lot 6A1 to you in the same exact size and configuration as you see it, it's my belief that it would meet code in all requirements. Another reason, or another fact that I'd like to bring to your attention, is that the reason that I believe the spirit of the 1 acre minimum with a minor subdivision is that often with a minor subdivision, the infrastructure is something less than what I call what the full subdivision ordinance would ordinarily require. You say, well, Jeff, in what ways? As you ladies and gentlemen know, in a minor subdivision, for example, the right-of-way can be as narrow as 35 feet. Ron, is that right?
Yes, sir.
35 feet, as opposed to the standard 60-foot minimum. For example, in a minor subdivision, there is no requirement for central sewage and water, by way of example. Also, there's typically no detention requirement as it relates to detention ponds in a 5-lot minor subdivision. Well, let's look at River Chase. In River Chase, we already have Sterling Boulevard, which is on a full-size right-of-way, a road fully built to parish standard, and in fact a public road. We have obviously central sewage and water. We obviously have a complete drainage system. The point is that this development meets all of the standards that your subdivision ordinance would require if this property were going through the regular subdivision process, with one exception, and that is this lot is smaller than 1 acre. You might say, well, Jeff, why don't you just move the line a little bit? Maybe take 6A and 6B, and Rob, Peter, Pay, Paul, and work something out. Honestly, there are business deals that were made with prospective purchasers and our tenants, and those deals have closed subject to the approvals based on the lot configuration you see, because I think the developer believed that the fact that he still had a 40,000 plus square lot would not present a problem to the Planning Commission if in fact you understood that all of the infrastructure surrounding the property, et cetera, exceeded standard. Again, I would repeat to you that if we had taken these five lots and gone through the full subdivision process, there would have been really no need for tentative or preliminary, because the infrastructure is built, it's already in place, and we actually could have created lots smaller than what is shown in lot 6A. So I certainly understand and respect staff's comments, because they are accurately telling you what the minor subdivision requires. But I would also ask that you take the other facts into consideration that I've given you, as I know you've done at least on a few other occasions on some cases that I've had through the years. And I would like you to, you know, certainly grant a waiver as it relates to the size of parcel 6A. If any of you have any questions, I'll be glad to address them when you're ready.
Thank you, Mr. Shane. Anyone else in the audience wish to speak on this? I'll close the floor to the public, bring it back to the commission. Mr. Matthews.
Jeff, one quick question, I guess. You said you all don't want to rob Peter to pay Paul and increase the size of this lot, because there are deals that have already been cut waiting on the approvals.
Yes, sir.
What happens to those deals if we don't approve?
Well, we're going to certainly have to do something. I mean, if you tell us that you think that there's a problem with lot 6A, we're going to have to find a way to get, what, another 3,024 square feet into that lot, or we're going to have to go through the full subdivision process. And I think when it comes back to you, I would suspect that there would be no need for tentative or preliminary. We'd present a final plat to you, and I don't believe there'd be any reason to object to the approval of the final plat, assuming again that all of the things required of full subdivision approval have either provided to you, or I think they've physically been built, approved by the parish already.
Well, is there a reason other than the fact that you've talked to or made, I guess, preliminary deals with tenants that you can't just adjust this a little bit? Is there some physical reason that can't be done?
Well, I guess you can never say that anything's impossible, but it was hard for us to understand why it might be necessary to do it. We took the minor subdivision route because it seemed simpler and easier, and quite frankly, at the time of filing, I don't think that the developer realized that he would need the waiver for lot 6A. We now realize that we need a waiver for lot 6A, but again, perhaps biased on my part, but we failed to see any prejudice to the parish in that had we gone through the full process, and staff, correct me if you disagree with my analysis, had we gone through the full subdivision process, I don't think this parcel would be considered deficient in size, and there would be no reason for you to deny.
This is really just a technical problem, and we only have a few hundred square feet that we're off. I don't really have a problem, but I think Jimmy has some questions, and I'll hold off. But
yes, sir.
Ms. Casabon, I believe you were next.
Yes, I have a question. I don't know, staff or Jeff. I don't have a problem with it being under the acre, as long as, do we look at what may have done this before, the building footprint of what is going in there? Are we basing it on the 0.74 acres, or are we basing it on an acre? In other words, the size of parking and that sort of thing. Do we have, in other words, will the building or the business fit on this particular size lot, or what do we do in that case, Ron?
Well, yeah, I mean, that's why
they have to meet all the requirements, right?
That's why they developed the parcel the way it is they understand they're going to have to fit a building on it, and that shouldn't be a problem. And just while we're on the subject, I need to make a correction. It's not 0.74 acres. It's 0.74 acres. Hey, it's a very
zero,
small.
I'm sorry. That's what I meant. Yeah, 0.74. Yeah. It's under an acre. So the building would be able to fit in this particular area.
Ms. Casabone, in that regard, when we procure our building permit, we recognize that we must meet every standard you have as it relates to setback, lot coverage, in any, you know, landscaping, lighting, et cetera. We have to make it work, and
correct,
we can. Our
right,
building plan for Lot 6A, in fact, does conform with all of your standards.
Right, and the common sense is it'll fit in there, right? And I don't really, I don't have a problem. I understand that we need to maybe straighten out, Ron, the to make it, I can see where the problem is. I'm thinking of this as from being in the zoning stage, it would be acceptable.
Yeah, well, it'd be minor, well within the zoning requirements, yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I'll make a motion to approve.
Second. Huh? We have a motion by Ms. Casabon to approve and a second by Mr. Willie. We have some other discussion. Mr. Davis?
Yeah, Jeff. The parcel in front of both of these parcels is 5A-1A, the green space parcel?
Yes.
Does that meet the requirements, or does it exceed the requirements?
It exceeds and, in fact, is not even required. What we elected to do, and again, hindsight 2020, but we thought we were doing it the right way, we thought that because we could only create five lots, we only picked the areas that we wished to develop, and we thought it would be an amenity both to the lot and to the public to create a green space area between there and the interstate. So to answer your question, there was no requirement for a green space servitude. That, in fact, could all be part of a lot. But we think it's better for the development, and again, better for maybe the viewing public driving up and down the interstate. We've been encouraged, as you know, through the years, the development community, to keep as much green as we can around the perimeter. This was an opportunity that we took to do so. We defined the lots by the sizes that you see, and that's why we're having our discussion.
And since you've already been in contact with the people that want to purchase these lots, it's a little bit too much inconvenience to say take off a couple of feet of the screen space and go ahead and make it within code of greater than 1 acre.
Yes, sir. I can tell you honestly that the transaction for Lot 6A has closed in the sense that the deal has been determined and the documents have been prepared subject to the approval by the Planning Commission creating Lot 6A as a lot of record.
All right. Thank you.
We didn't, I don't say that presumptively. I say it with respect.
Okay. Anyone else wish to speak? All right, we have a motion and a second. Mr. Willie, didn't you second Ms. Casabon?
I will.
Okay, Mr. Matthews seconded. Ms. Casabon made the motion.
That's with the waiver,
Matthews,
correct? Approval subject to waiver, okay.
All right, please vote. It takes 8 votes to pass this. We don't have a problem. We got a 10 to nothing. So that was approved.
Thank you.
All right. We go to page 2. Another minor subdivision, MS 14-03-015. It's a 6.86 acre parcel into parcels A and B, Ward 6, District 11. The owner is Michael and Kim Avocado. The surveyor is Kelly McEwen Associates. The Parish Council District Representative is Honorable Steve Stefancic. Staff?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The owner of the property is proposing to create two parcels from one parent parcel. Since the private drive would only provide access to one parcel within the minor subdivision, said drive is not required to be built to any parish standard. Now, therefore, the staff recommends approval of the proposed minor subdivision requests.
Okay. Thank you. Anyone in the audience wish to speak? I'll close the floor to the public, bring it back to the commission.
Yeah, I don't think I need to speak.
Okay, thank you. Does anyone have any question for Ms. Avocado? Mr. Matthews, please come forward.
No, I don't really have a question for her. I got really got more of a question for staff.
Okay.
Looking at the plat we have here, it really looks to me like this road will access both of these parcels, not just one of the parcels.
Well, you have to create a driveway from the front parcel to get to the back parcel. I mean, an internal driveway for the front parcel is permitted as long as it's a singular driveway that accesses the same parcel at the rear. The main focus of the code is to require that the front parcel have public road access, which this does.
Okay.
All right.
I move to approve.
Second.
We have a motion by Mr. Matthews to approve, seconded by Mr. Davis. Any further discussion? Please vote. Motion carries. Thank you. Next item, MS 14-03-016, lots 1, 3, and 4 into lots 1A, 3A, and 4A, Ward 4, District 5. The owner is N59 Ventures, LLC. Surveyors Randall W. Brown and Associates. Parish Council District Representatives, Honorable Marty Gould. Staff.
Hey, Mr. Chairman. This property is located on the northeast corner of LA 59 and East Coop Drive. It's the property right next door to the Popeyes down on the highway there. This is part of an existing minor subdivision where two lots are being re-subdivided under the minimum 1 acre requirement. That's the reason for the public hearing. The owner is proposing to reconfigure an existing 5-lot minor subdivision by taking portions of lots 3 and 4 and adding said parts to lot 1. If you take a look at your site plan and your packet behind the staff reports, you can see where the adjustments are being made with the dashed lines. The proposal does not meet parish code since the lots being reduced in size result in both lots not meeting the minimum 1 acre lot size requirement. And based on the amount of the total acreage involved, which is 6.45 acres, the staff fails to understand why the owner can't simply keep the 1 acre minimum for both lots as was originally approved. However, it should be noted that the parcels are zoned commercial as well as the previous case that we reviewed, in which the district permits permits less than 1 acre parcels, if not for having to comply with the minor subdivision code requirements. The staff does not recommend approval of the proposed minor subdivision request because it does not comply with the code. Additionally, a waiver of the regulations is required in order to approve this minor subdivision request relative to the lot size issue. Therefore, a 2/3 majority vote of the membership is required, which is 8 members, to approve this request under Section 40-100, Waivers of Regulations of Ordinance 499.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Members of the Commission, Mike Soche. I'm a partner in North 59 Investments and president of Gulf States Real Estate. Not unlike, as a matter of fact, very much like the previous case that Mr. Shane had before you. We have the same, very similar issue here at North 59 Investments. This project is right across the street from the parish complex here where Popeyes is located. You know that that we have been working with a food store, a large food store chain, to go there. We have successfully been able to bring that chain back to the area. They have increased the size of their store from about 42 to 53,000 square feet. That's one item. Item number two is we originally were working with a regional pizza place that was going to take lot 4 and they needed an acre. I call it a blessing. Smoothie King has showed up and I'm here to announce that they have entered into a purchase agreement to purchase the 0.524 acres that we have shown here on the map. So they need less. It's a small 1,500 square foot Smoothie King store. They don't need an acre of ground. As a matter of fact, they just built one over on 59 near, on Highway 190 near 59. And fortunately, that allowed me to increase the size of the parking area for the food store to accommodate their needs, which also ate up slightly into lot 3A. What was planned for lot 3A were adjoining shops, small shop space, about 7,700 square feet of shops. That is going to be reduced to about 6,000 square feet of shops. Again, the food store got a little wider, got a little deeper, needed more parking, and these lot changes will accommodate the food store needs. which we hope to formally announce shortly, but also accommodate Smoothie King's needs, who are under contract and hope to gain approval tonight for this matter. Again, as I don't want to reiterate everything that Mr. Shane said, but you could literally take those comments. This site is a consolidated project. We have cross-access, cross-parking with all parcels. Each one of our parcels has to maintain a certain parking ratio to meet the parish requirements. So there are no variances in requirements in the parish requirements. And if we had gone through the full subdivision process versus the minor subdivision process, and we had known of the smaller needs of a Smoothie King, they have a brand new, beautiful prototype out now. And the changing needs of our food store, we would have probably done the process a little differently. But at the end of the day, all of these parcels will comply with the parish requirements. We are zoned for, I believe, the lots, 20,000 square feet is the minimum lot size in our zoning category. The food store parcel is actually zoned 8C3 at this location. And similar to River Chase, we have full parish utilities, we have full detention, full drainage study. There are no aspects of the minor subdivision ordinance that we are taking advantage of from a physical standpoint to accommodate this project. So with that being said, on behalf of N59 Ventures and Smoothie King, we'd appreciate your approval of this request.
Thank you, Mr. Soche. Anyone else in the audience wish to speak on this? I'll close the floor to the public. Bring it back to the commission. Mr. Davis.
Mr. Soche, the only difference I find between this and the previous case is that you have Highway 59 in front of you. So your traffic impact is going to be a lot more. You'll have many more turnoffs. If you have multiple number of businesses next to the Popeyes, mm-hmm. instead of just having one or two, if you're breaking this up, wouldn't you have a additional turnoff here for lot four instead of going to one additional bigger lot four?
No, as a matter of fact, the driveway that you see into lot four, the property line runs down the center of it, because that driveway will be shared between Smoothie King and the food store.
We are not
changing any access points from our previously approved traffic study. We will still need to put in the right turn slip lane at such time as it's needed. As a matter of fact, we're doing counts right now, a mini traffic study, so to speak, for the parish traffic engineer to make sure that the Smoothie King will not generate enough traffic for the right turn lane. We're going to put the driveway in as shown.
Okay,
if we have enough trips to put the turn lane in now, we'll go ahead and do that also. It's our belief that the food store is really going to be the thing that will justify that.
So you're telling me here that the Smoothie King, where this currently says the restaurant is, there will be no entrance from 59 directly to it?
They will share an entrance with lot one, and which will be the food store track. There will be no other curb cuts on the 59.
Okay, so there will only be one turn in coming off of 59 just north of lot two.
Correct. That's correct.
Right. Yeah, Popeyes doesn't have one, so you're okay there. Yeah, okay. Right now I was thinking you'd have multiple businesses in there and another turnoff going to lot number one, which would put two turnoffs right at that small intersection.
No,
okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Ms. Casabon.
Yes, I know that there's multiple people that's been looking for a food store that live on 59, and to the point like where there were, and I think this is, as long as we didn't change any of the other and it fits in, I'll make a motion to approve.
We have a motion
with the
by
waiver.
Ms. Casabon to approve, seconded by
with the waiver.
Mr. Hines. Any further discussion? Please vote. Well, there's the eighth vote, so it's going to pass. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right, next item is re-subdivision review. RS 14-04-018, South Abita Springs, Square 19, Lot 19A into Lots 19A1 and 19A2, Ward 3, District 2. The owners Andrew Muller and others. Surveyors, DNS Surveys, Parish Council District Representatives, Honorable Dennis Sharp. Staff?
Hey, Mr. Chairman, please refer to your site plans attached to the staff report. This proposal is rather unique due to the improper sale of a portion of Lot 19A by Alexis Mindens to an Andrew and Celine Muller, who purchased the southern half of said lot. Again, just to, you know, the lot, these were actually originally four lots of record. The original owner, like I said, as I mentioned, combined these lots into one parcel and then subsequently went and sold the northern half of that one lot illegally, basically, is what he did. Staff understands the situation. Mr. Mindens, prior to 2012, combined the four lots together to create this Lot 19A. However, in 2012, Mr. Mindens sold the southern half of Lot 19A to the Mullers illegally, which has an existing house on said half, and sets an application request to re-subdivide the property into two smaller lots was never filed. Therefore, as a result of this predicament, a cloud on the titles of the property owners involved exists, and although Parish Code does not allow for the re-subdivision of property back into smaller lots, it seems that the only reasonable way in which to rectify this impropriety for all concerned would be to allow for this re-subdivision to take place and to grant a waiver. Therefore, due to the circumstances and to provide relief to the parties involved, the staff recommends approval of the proposed minor subdivision request back into two lots, into two sets of two lots, into two lots, excuse me. Furthermore, a waiver of the regulations, as I mentioned, is required in order to approve the re-subdivision request relative to the lot size reduction. Therefore, a two-thirds majority vote of the full membership of the commission, eight members, is required in order to approve pursuant to the waiver requirements of Subdivision Ordinance 499.
Thank you. Anyone in the audience wish to speak on this?
I'm here just to represent the owner. He's out on deployment.
And you are who?
James Meyer.
Okay.
It's a military guy that's on deployment. He's out of the country. I make a motion. Anybody else want to talk?
Mr. Matthews.
I'll make a motion to approve. It's just clearing up the situation.
I'll second.
All right. Ms. Casabon made a motion to approve, seconded by Mr. Hines. Mr. Matthews, you had a...
I do. who owns both of these lots?
Well, as I indicated in my staff report, actually, one person illegally owns half of this property.
Who is that person?
That's the Mullers, yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You might want to come on up to the mic.
That's the person you're representing?
No, I'm representing. We're actually, my son wants to buy the vacant lot.
Okay, and please, so I'm please, just please representing. Please state your name and address for the record.
Sure. It's James Meyer. And 500 Aspen Lane in Covington.
Okay, the Mr. Miller owns 19A1 or 19A2?
He owns 19A1.
Okay, and who owns 19A2?
Alex
Midas.
Okay, so Mr. Midas is the one that sold part of this lot illegally to Mr. Muller?
Yes.
Okay. And we're being asked to reward his illegal sale with a waiver and an approval. I, for one, have a real problem with doing that. You know, he screwed up, and now he's coming to ask for forgiveness rather than trying to ask for permission. And I, for one, I just don't think that's, you know, you guys need to figure out a better way to do this than to ask us to reward the illegal activity, and I'm against it.
Thank you, Mr. Matthews. Mr. Davis?
Yeah, just one question for staff. So because they never filed, that's why we have this situation. Is that correct?
Right. Originally, the gentleman had four lots.
Right.
small lots of record, and rather than combine, which he legally could have done at the time, two of the lots to make these two lots.
Right.
He decided to make one nice big home site. But again, for whatever reason, he went ahead and sold half of it with a house already on it to somebody without coming back to us to try to ask for it to go back into these two lots. That has been done before with the commission, where people have subdivided four lots into one and then said, oh, you know, really, I didn't want to do that. And they've come back and they asked for approval to resubdivide them back into two lots, and we've granted that approval. In this case, the people who bought the house already there were not aware that it was an illegal sale, and so they're kind of in a box.
Okay.
That's the situation.
So I understand now. So it's basically, we granted approval to have this one big lot, and they just never acted on it, basically.
They never came back to resubdivide it back into these two lots. He just sold the south half illegally.
But doesn't that naturally default back to what it was before if they never come and file for it?
No, because the code requires that when you have small lots of record, you have to combine them, but we only require to combine at least two of them together. In this particular case, the gentleman who owned all four lots combined it into one. He could have come back, he could have come in at that time and created two lots, but he chose not to do that.
Okay. Yeah, I'd like to, it's too bad the individual's not here. Yeah.
Mr. Willie?
So the proposed lots are still twice as large as surrounding lots.
I mean, they conform because they have to be, at least two of them have to be combined together. So, okay, yeah, they would conform to the majority of the lots.
They look like they're still twice as large as previous lots.
Right, and they would conform with most people who would come in under this situation and create a, you know, take two lots to make one. That's typically how they would do it.
Yes, sir. Legal counsel here, Mike.
I was just going to ask, Ron, do you know what the zoning classification is on the property?
Yeah, it's a zone A4.
A4. So when the gentleman combined all four lots into one lot, it had the effect of complying with the lot size requirements of the zoning code.
That's correct. Right.
And now he has divided them again, putting that one lot out of compliance.
Well, that's what he's trying to do. Yes, correct. That's why he would need the waiver. Yes.
Right, but that's different from a situation where he had four 25-foot lots and just failed to turn it into two lots.
That's correct. Right.
I mean, he's basically trying to go backwards in a process that the parish has been encouraging with these substandard lots in combining them to comply with our lot sizes.
Sure.
Okay, thanks.
Mr. Matthews?
Are we going to have to bring this before zoning and rezone this now, or what?
Zoning, I don't think the zoning wouldn't help, because if he went to an A4A, that would one thing be a spot zone, and secondly, it still requires a 60-foot minimum frontage, and he only has 58.
So they have really screwed this up six ways from funding.
Yeah, but what I'm trying to say is that is a matter of, in the past, at least on two occasions, we have granted them to go back to creating two lots from the original one lot because there was originally four lots, and they created one lot and then said, oh, I made a mistake, I want to go back and make two lots out of it. Again, under the situation, if he originally had come in and said, I want to create these two lots, we would legally be allowing him to do that because he's combining lots together under our contiguous lot rule ordinance, which requires a combined lot.
And what you suggested is that in the past, people have come and asked permission, and we have granted it.
That's correct, at least on two occasions I'm aware of,
and
yes.
Now they're asking for forgiveness instead of permission.
Well, I guess that's one way of putting it, yes.
Do we know when the house was built, approximately?
You know when it was built?
It looks like it's about 10 years old.
I don't know if it's that old, but
it was built long before all this started then.
It was sold in 2012.
Okay. All right, any further discussion? We have a motion and a second to approve resubdivision review RS 14-04-018. Please vote. Once again, this takes eight votes to...
Eight to two.
All right, we've We've got eight yeas and two nays, so it goes as approved. Thank you.
Thank you.
Tentative subdivision review, SD 14-04-003, Money Hill Plantation, Phase 7, Ward 6, District 6. Developer owners, Money Hill Plantation, LLC. The engineer is J.V. Burks and Associates, Incorporated. The Parish Council District Representative is Honorable Richard Tanner. Staff?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This proposal is a total of 48 lots. The property is a zoned PLUD, Plan Unit Development. It's an extension of an existing subdivision that's been out there for a long time with Money Hill. Staff comments, the dedication block needs to be corrected to depict Money Hill Plantation Phase 7 and not just Money Hill Plantation. All the other requirements, the red line comments have been met. Informational items include the parish code requires that land clearing permit be applied for before he obtains a work order in conjunction with the preliminary subdivision review process. And a preliminary draft copy of the Declaration of Covenants and Restrictions needs to be submitted to this office prior to the developer receiving a work order in conjunction with preliminary subdivision review process. Staff recommends approval. Engineering has one comment.
Need location of existing or proposed servitudes, labeling the servitude in the rear of lots 407 through 415, lot 399, lot 400, and lots 417 through 425. And then the informational items is the notice of intent and the LDEQ permit letter needed prior to work order, and the SWIP maintained on site for stormwater inspections.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Shane.
Thank you, Mr. Daugherty. Jeff Shane of Jones Fusel, representing the owner and developer, Money Hill Plantation, LLC. We're in full accord with staff comments. We understand the things that are required and also the informational items that we need to attend to as we go forward with preliminary. If any of you have any questions, I'd be glad to address them. Otherwise, after your discussion and vote, I would like to make a few comments about this phase that might be of help to you when we come back to you for preliminary.
Thank you, Mr. Shane. Mr. Randolph.
I move to approve.
Second. All right, we have a motion by Mr. Randolph to approve, seconded by Mr. Richard. Mr. Matthews.
Jeff and staff, does the amount of green space in here come up to the code? That's Ron. Jeff, you can answer this then.
Yeah,
the walking space, the walking trails, do they actually connect to other walking trails, or do we know?
Yes, they do, and we do meet the green space requirements. This is in conformity with the PUD that laid out the PUD plan.
Okay.
And in fact, if I could have just the benefit of, I don't think it'll take more than a minute. What I was going to mention to you was that since we have filed, we have further revised this plan. We did not get the revised plan to staff in time to further advertise, but I think you'll be pleased to know that when we come to you for preliminary, we will also be seeking a revision to this tentative if you see fit to grant it. And that revision will add another 7 acres to this phase. And of that 7 acres, there's only one lot being added, a 1 acre lot, which means the balance of it is going to be green space. So there's going to be even more green space. There's going to be one additional lot. Camp Hill Drive, the right of way, will be widened from 60 to 80 feet. And so you're going to see what I think all of which are good and significant changes on the revised tentative, and that's how our preliminary will be designed. Had we gotten that to staff early enough and it could have been advertised, we would be presenting that to you this evening.
Can you tell us where that additional lot would be?
Yeah, it's at the northwest corner. It's lot 440. So if you will look, you can see, I guess, 438 on your plat.
Mm-hmm. Maybe the numbering changes. It's right here, 401. Okay. Yeah.
It would be adjacent to lot 438. We renumbered the lots. That's why I said it's 440. But there's only one additional lot being added of similar size. I would say there's roughly about a six acre addition as it relates to green space and additional right-of-way.
Okay, any further discussion? We have a motion and a second to approve. Please vote. Motion carries. Thank you. Well, let's see, that's no preliminaries. Old business.
Thank you.
Entering Parish right-of-way. Partridge Street, Ward 4, District 5. Request to enter Parish right-of-way for the purpose of gaining access to property. The debtor is McCallum LLC. Parish Council District Representative is Honorable Marty Gould. Staff?
I'm again, Councilman. My name is Sam Camp. I live at 139 Bode Lane, and I want to apologize for my first time up. I think I was shook when my neighbors came up here, the problem we have with that. So I got a little shook when I got through that. And I haven't spoken. I thought I would. I didn't know I'd be speaking through the whole council, so that kind of embarrassed me a little bit. I thought I'd just be speaking to Mr. Gould. I didn't know that. So I apologize for that, true. And I know we're going to get back to that. We'll get it right. I was not objecting to do the street. I know this, I don't know what a street is. Maybe it's 40 feet or 20 feet or whatever it is. I wouldn't want to damage 20 or 40 feet to go back to those lots. That's what I'd make it a gravel road, no problem.
That was another
case. I know, okay, but I want to apologize for that and get to this. And reason, this is a little bit different here. This is it, and I've got the builder, Mike Martin, out here for who is a professional builder. If you see the end of Partridge Road, it's 550 feet, the best I can understand it, end of Partridge Road. When they paved the roads a number of years in the parish, they stopped right at that last house, if you'll see that picture. If you have a picture of that, if you don't, I've got one here. Of that property. And so when the parish came to that end, the street was open to the end of the street to begin with. There's a street there. And they stopped with the paving right at that point. I own all those lots on both sides of that area. We're not planning to build now, but I'd like to survey those lots. I'd like to open to get to that street, the ditches and everything there. I'd like to have access to that, get there into that, and make the drainage better while we do these lots. We are building some houses right up the street next to that on the paved area that we're building those houses there now. So that's basically what we wanted to do. And I understand it would be a regular street like the parish, gravel road, which it was before, and it is there. We just like to go down and open those ditches for draining and survey those lots. We combine in those small lots, like you said, and I can't remember the dimensions of them, but they put them together so they meet the dimensions of the parish at that point.
Okay, thank
yes,
you.
Sir.
Mr. Keller, you have any comments other than?
This is just an extension of a previously approved resolution, so we don't have any comments, no, sir.
Okay, thank you. Ms. Casabon.
Yes, that's what I'm making sure I understand what's happening. We approved this. He just didn't get it done, and therefore he's asking for an extension? Or?
Yes, it was approved, and he didn't submit the required documentation within the six-month period.
Yeah.
Okay. So we've already approved that. So I'll make a motion to approve.
Yeah.
We have a motion and a second by Mr. Hines. Mr. Randolph? Okay. Any further discussion? Please vote. Motion carries. Thank you.
Can I ask a question? Does that mean I have to do it within 6 months to build the road?
Yeah.
No, it doesn't mean that. Okay.
Excuse me, Mr. Camp.
Mr. Camp, yeah.
And staff, correct me if I'm misspeak, but I believe you have 6 months to provide all the required documentation to the departments for the activity to take place in the right-of-way. Is that correct?
Yes, to obtain a work order, he would need to submit all the required documentation within 6 months. And then he has 2 years from the extension date, which is today, to complete construction.
You understand that?
No,
sir. Have to provide all the necessary documents to the departments for the work that you are going to conduct.
To survey the property and then?
All of the paperwork that they require, and they'll work with you to make sure that you know all of the documents that you need to provide to them, and you have 2 years from this approval in which to complete the work.
Okay, okay.
Is that clear?
I think it is. I'm going to ask them to clarify. Thank y'all. I appreciate it.
Okay, thank you. All right, do we have any new business? Do I hear a motion to adjourn? Thank y'all. Thank you.